Let's graph the equation y equals 1/3 x plus 1. And we're going to do it two ways. First, we'll put values in for x and find y. So once we have those, we can get the points and we can plot them on our graph here. Then we'll check it with slope-intercept formula. So let's start out by putting values in. And I think we'll start by putting 3 in for x. Because if we put 3 in for x, 1/3 times 3, that's 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. That's a little bit easier to do it that way. 0 is always a good number to put in because we know it's going to fit on our graph here. So 0, 1/3 times 0, that's 0 plus 1. That gives us 1. And let's put negative 3 in. 1/3 times negative 3, that gives us negative 1 plus 1, that's 0. So these are the points that we'll graph for this equation y equals 1/3 x plus 1. We could have put any values in, just these are a little easier to work with. They show up on our graph and they're whole numbers. So let's see, we have x is 3, y is 2. So 1, 2, 3, and then up 2 for the y. That's our first point. X is 0, y is 1. So go to 0, 1. And then finally, x is negative 3, and y is 0. So right there. And that's the line for y equals 1/3 x plus 1. Let's put a line through this, and then arrows to show that this goes into infinity. So that's our line. Let's check it with the slope-intercept formula. So we have y equals mx plus b. B is the y-intercept, and that's 1. So what that means is the line is going to intercept the y-axis at 1. So we go down and find 1, and right there it is. And it's on the same line, which isn't surprising. Next, we're going to look at this 1/3. This is the slope as rise over run. So we go to our y-intercept, we rise 1, and go over 1, 2, 3. And we can do that again. From this point, we rise 1 and go over 1, 2, 3. And we can just keep doing that. All those points are on the line. Likewise, we could go back here and go down 1 and over 1, 2, 3. From there, go down 1, 1, 2, 3. All the points are on our line. So that's the graph for the linear equation y equals 1/3 x plus 1. We could put other values in for x and get values for y. And all of those points, they would fall on this line right here. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.